about encroaching dread. And the thing about encroaching dread is that if you like horror movies or books in which bad things happen to people, you develop an affection for the concept of encroaching dread. And you begin to fancy yourself a person who maybe deals with it well. You know, because, yeah, I read about those people all the time, and I see them in the movies, and when it happens to my friends, I smile knowingly. You know, oh yes, I'm familiar with your situation. But when the dread actually begins to encroach on your own life, it has quite a different flavor to it. The sort of flavor that makes you want to vomit, right? And then you think briefly, it crosses your mind. You think, man, if a friend of mine was telling me about this, I would find his situation quite romantic. But sitting here in those shoes, there's just nothing good at all about it. And you start searching through your mind for the good things about it that you thought that seemed so clear to you when it was happening in a Catherine Ann Porter book or something, you know? And no, those things are lies. I'll remember when I emerge from this that it's actually no good and it shouldn't be romanticized or spoken glowingly of. But as sure as I'm standing here, as soon as you emerge from the cloud, you go, oh, that was awesome. I hear them squeal, I see them preen. Fans all spread out, neat and clean. We both hit the deck.